We'd like to start this meeting today, call it to order. This is the Weber County Commission meeting on the 25th of June, 10 o'clock. Maybe 10:02. I'm a titch late getting started, sorry about that. Anyway, we welcome y'all here today. It's a good morning. Our invocation this morning will be by Rick Grover, Pledge of Allegiance by Steve Burton, and Father Today by Commissioner Four. We'll go to there.
Our dear Heavenly Father, we're grateful for the opportunity to meet this day, especially under such favorable circumstances. We're thankful for the opportunity that we have this upcoming week to celebrate our independence. We're thankful for the men and women who have served in preserving our freedoms through the years. We pray that as our various communities celebrate the 4th of July, that there may be a spirit of peace around each one of their events in Weber County. We're thankful for all that was given unto us, and we pray that as these good men serve in this meeting this day as our commissioners, that spirit of wisdom and peace may be upon them as they make decisions in our county's behalf. We're thankful for all that was given unto us, and we say these things in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So, we've had some previous discussions about all the benefits that we enjoy living in this great county, Weber County. We talk about the trail system, we talk about the opportunities for outdoor recreation, which is very true. But I saw in the paper, I think just last week, that Weber County is rated as the most diverse county in the state. I don't know if you saw that or not. And I think that's a cause for celebration. One thing that that I've always enjoyed about Weber County and comparing it to some other counties across the state that have had the opportunity to visit for primarily legislative reasons is that we have a mindset up here that's a little different than other counties in a lot of cases, and that's because we are very diverse. And that's a healthy thing. I look back on my early days in Ogden Valley when it was not very diverse. And of course, we didn't really recognize the difference, but you know, we have people from other countries, from other states, people moving from in the state into Weber County, and it's very healthy for us as a county, I believe. I look of all the people from California and other states, countries that have moved into Ogden Valley the last number of years, and it's changed the complexion of Ogden Valley, but I think for the better. I think that's been a good thing. I think we can embrace that. I think that we can celebrate that as a county. So with that, I had a couple of quotes, if I might, Mr. Chair, that talk about diversity. And one of the quotes from Maya Angelou is, "It's time for parents to teach young people early on that in diversity there is beauty and there is strength." Cesar Chavez said, "We need to help students and parents cherish and preserve the ethic and cultural diversity that nourishes and strengthens this community and this nation." So I would say, again, we need to celebrate this because I think this helps celebrate, strengthens, and nourishes our local Weber County. That's my thoughts, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. We appreciate that, Commissioner. Well, so today, that takes us through item D. So we'll go to item E, which is public comment. Anybody who's come today to address the commission, if you're not on the agenda, now would be the time for you to stand up and come say hi. Tell us your problems. I don't see any. Very good. We'll go to the next item on the agenda, consent items. Item 1, F1, is the approval of warrants 1849 through 1850 and 4403 3326 through 440589 in the amount of $2,258,885. Second is request for approval of purchase orders in the amount of $181,197. Third is request for approval of beer licenses, and fourth is approval of business licenses. So, to that, is there any comments or questions, commissioners?
Great job in lining that out. I don't have any questions, Mr. Chair.
None?
I'm okay.
How about a motion then, somebody? Ricky, I'm sorry, I always keep forgetting to go to you. Why don't we go to have you and have you give us a rundown on these warrants?
You bet. For our 21 purchase orders this week came to $121,000. 27% of that amount, or $50,000, is for the Golden Spike Event Center, and that's to install a playground, which was purchased with grant funds. 15%, or $28,000, is for property management, and that is to purchase LED lights for the bottom two floors of the Weber Center, which will be nice to get those installed and get some savings in utilities there. 13%, or $23,000, is for the conference center, and that will go to HVAC repairs. 10%, or $18,000, will be used to purchase by the roads department to purchase chipping oil and signage, and the paramedics department, paramedic fund, to purchase gurneys. And then 8%, or $14,000, is for the jail, and that will go to purchase inmate clothing. As far as checks, we issued 264 checks this week for $2.3 million. A fourth of that amount, or $588,000, is for the transfer station, and that's disposal costs. 19%, or $432,000, is transportation tax funds going back to Marriott Slaterville for their work on Pioneer Road. And then we have two amounts for 13%, or about $300,000, the jail, and that's primarily culinary, but also some medical services, quartermaster, and utilities, and as well as the sheriff's department to purchase new radios, the Motorola radios. And then lastly, 7%, or $153,000, is for the paramedic fund, and that is to purchase a new ambulance.
Thank you. So it's interesting, you have changed the format whereby we get the warrants, and we appreciate that. And if you notice today, we always have a meeting prior to this meeting to go over these warrants, make sure we understand all the billing and who's spending what and why and how. Today we canceled that meeting because it was all set right there, very plain, easy to understand, and I appreciate that. Well, you know it.
Good.
Worked out very good.
Worked out good.
Thank you.
One thing I want to comment,
if please.
I can, Mr. Chair, is that I'm really glad to see Sean and Bryce and that group here in our local building continue with the LED upgrades. Not only do we participate with Woodbury on that in the overall cost, or we'll get reimbursed for some of that, when we did that out the Golden Spike the first year in just that building alone, by doing those upgrades, we saved $27,000 in just power costs. Those are ongoing costs to the county by doing that. So the same thing will ring true for this building, and I'm really glad to see them. We've done the third floor, and now doing the other floors is great. It's wonderful that we're moving forward with that.
Good. All right.
With that, Mr. Chair, I'll make a motion that we accept the consent items, or item F, like Foxtrot, as written.
Motion?
Second.
And a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? It's approved. Very good. First action item today is request for approval of interlocal agreement by and between Weber County Health Department, Weber County Human Services, for the Prosperity Center of Excellence. Christopher Crockett.
Thank you, Commissioners. Before you is an interlocal agreement for the creation of the Prosperity Center of Excellence. This is an agreement of three governmental entities, the Weber County, Weber Human Services, and the Weber Morgan Health Department. The Interlocal Cooperation Act allows governmental entities to pool funding resources and to engage in joint endeavors such as this. I wanted to give you a few of the technical aspects of the agreement, and then I'll turn some time over to the commission. And we also have Brian Bennion and Kevin Eastman, the directors of the Health Department and Human Services here, who can really speak about the neat things behind this this agreement, all of the great things that are going on. But just two quick things. In the recitals of the agreement, it states that the parties each have statutory responsibilities to help address a variety of social, public, and behavioral health problems, which include, among other things, intergenerational poverty, social determinants of health, substance abuse, and economic development. And then the next one talks about the parties have identified a need to work together to address these problems by combining interdisciplinary expertise and forming cross-sector coalitions that will engage community stakeholders to identify root causes to those problems, remove systematic barriers, and work toward a common goal of collective well-being for all Weber County residents. And so this Prosperity Center, which will be managed by a director, and we also have the director who has been hired to run that that center, Melissa Freegang, she's here as well. The Prosperity Center will operate as a division of the Health Department. Melissa will be an employee of the Health Department. She will be, although she's an employee of the Health Department, the Interlocal sets up an administrative board that will govern this center, which consists of one member of the commission and then the directors for Weber Human Services and the Weber Morgan Health Department. The term of this agreement is for 5 years, but it can be extended up to 50 years. And so that's the technical stuff, but I would invite the members of the commission or Kevin, Melissa, or Brian to comment about what the actual purpose of this center will be and what we intend to accomplish by creating it.
So I'll start this out. This was a suggestion by Kevin Eastman, Brian Bennion, that we look at this. And I thought it was a great suggestion. We've gone ahead and put this together now. And we, on top of this, we've received recently a report, a study, that Andy Beatles from Weber Housing Authority contracted for. And it's it's kind of all come together at the same time. It wasn't necessarily intended to be that way, but it's happened. And so now we're in the middle of organizing this and putting it all together and deciding what our organizational structure will look like. And we all knew what it was going to look like at the top, but it's everything down below it now. And so as we get this put together, hopefully we can have some major impact on the housing and intergenerational poverty and all these issues that we're starting to have, even some of the homelessness that's starting to creep into Weber County. You know, we've, since Salt Lake's done this Rio Grande project, we were wondering if that would affect us or not, and then we're finally seeing it is starting to affect us. Our homeless numbers are going up a little, and we believe that that's coming, as a result, that's coming out of Salt Lake County, and that the Rio Grande project that they've done. So anyway, we're getting into this, and we're trying to react to it, and I'm really excited about the direction that we're heading here in the county. This is a new direction, something that we've never envisioned before. And I just want to congratulate the people that have had the effort to put this together because they have a view for the future, a vision for it that has not existed before. So I'm really excited about it. Would either any folks care to comment to this? Brian Bennion.
Well, thanks, commissioners. Appreciate the opportunity to say just a few things about the Center of Excellence. As a health department.
Well, introduce yourself.
Oh, sorry. Brian Bennion. I'm the executive director of the Weber Morgan Health Department.
Thank you.
You know, our emphasis, of course, is public health. And can't think of better partners to work with as we work with the County Commission and also Weber Human Services as we look at the public health issues that impact the community. How can we work together? And we see the Center of Excellence as we talk about prevention. If we can prevent things, it's worth, as they say, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. And I think we all believe that. And we know that we can do it better together as we coordinate our efforts, as we look at intergenerational poverty, as we look at homelessness and substance abuse, those sort of things that are impacting our community. We're excited to be a part of this and appreciate the support of the commission in doing this. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Evan?
I was just merely hoping to answer any questions versus presenting, but just like Brian said, very excited about this. We know that if enough of the risk factors that we're trying to prevent from occurring line up in people's lives, that's where homelessness and poverty, a lot of the things are evident in their lives. So we can't just keep pouring dollars into treatment. We've got to cut some of these things off if we can before they occur, and educate people and hopefully turn around situations and make people's lives more prosperous. And so that's the idea behind it. I just echo what Brian said.
Thank you. Mrs. Freegang.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Melissa Freegang. And I think in 5 minutes, I'll be officially the new director of the Prosperity Center of Excellence. So I've been asked to just give a couple of really quick updates, and I promise, Commissioner, it will be quick. I presented to you guys in depth on the IGP initiative, and I just want to give you a quick update on that. So for the past month, I've been really trying to be on a listening tour, hear about everything that's going on. I just returned from a Weber Human Services Prevention Conference and really integrating with the Weber Human Services and the prevention team on the Weber Morgan Health Department. We've brought in two grants that we're already working on, the IGP grants. One is the Integrated Community Action Now, which you are aware of. And just a quick update. So we have 16 households that we've onboarded, 25 families in those 16 households, 30 adults and 41 children that are receiving services. We started out the grant last year in September of 18 with 8 agencies and initiatives, and we are now wrapping in about 218 different agencies around the families that we're working with. So a lot of hard work's been done. We have a couple of positive media reports, which has been great. And the agencies that we're wrapping around families, we average about 42 agencies around each family. So that's a lot. I mean, a lot of times families will get one agency or three agencies, but to wrap 42 means we're really moving the needle. So moving the needle, we have moved 3 families out of the budget in, which is typically the safe place that they go when they are homeless, and we've put them into stable housing. We have one family that was in unsafe housing, helped them access the Lantern House, and then transition on to more stable living conditions. We have 100% of our children now are covered on medical insurance. We've moved up to 90% of them have had a well visit, and our educational attainment. We started out with 58% of our children that were language arts proficient at grade level. We're now up to 94% of them that are at grade level, which is huge. In terms of the research, we know that children who are at grade level, when they're reading at grade level through their academic achievement, they're more likely to graduate, they're more likely to, or less likely to have chronic absenteeism, and they're more likely to be employed later on and be successful at adults. And then in math, we started out with 37% of them proficient, and we're now up to 53% of them proficient. So those are just a smattering of the indicators and moving the needle on some of the outcomes of our families, but I wanted to share that with you today.
Questions?
Well, I love that Weber County, along with the Weber Human Services and Weber Morgan Health Department, we have a proactive program now that is using outcome-based data and to do the best for these folks in Weber County. I'm proud to be a part of this little program. It's wonderful. So if when people say, what are we doing? Well, we're getting we have results now with at least 30 adults and 41 children we can point directly to, which other communities I don't think can be quite so specific. So I'm really, really proud of you folks putting this together. It's a good deal, really a good It's a good thing.
I don't know if you noticed in that, she said we were servicing 16 households, and in those 16 households were 25 families.
Right.
Well, you started talking about the social ills and how hard it is to work with some of these families. 25 families and 16 households. So many of these are on top of each other. And that's, of course, many of the major problems she's working with. All right. Well, any questions, Gage?
Well, no questions. I appreciate everybody that's been involved with this process. I'm excited to see this moving forward. Last week, we approved the economic development package. Tomorrow, we'll have a press conference. We'll even take this farther. I'm convinced that in order to have economic development and prosperity in any county, you have to hit every level of that community. We just can't concentrate at the top or the middle. We have to rise from the lower and bring everybody up. I think between our economic development initiative going forward, combined with this, the timing's right to lift that, the prosperity in this county, and to give job opportunities to people that probably haven't had opportunities before. So I'm excited to see these two initiatives, even though they're separate initiatives, they're really tied at the hip in my mind. They depend, and they're interdependent on each other to be successful. And I would hope, and I've had some discussions with Melissa, I think she understands the importance that what we do and what we accomplish on the economic development initiative will have a great impact and vice versa. So the two initiatives coming together at this point in time, in my opinion, are the best thing that we've seen in a long time in this county. And I appreciate the support. Appreciate the support of the health department, Weber Human Services, and obviously Melissa. We've got the captain and the chair that needs to be there and move this thing forward.
Well, thank you, Commissioner. I'm way excited too, and I've told our director that I want to get together with you two in the near future and finish laying out this organizational chart. We've got the top done, we've done the heavy lifting, but we got a ways to go yet. So we're going to have one more meeting to do that, and then we'll be fully operational up. Melissa's already brought us several opportunities already. So I'm excited as heck about this, too. Thank you very much for the presentation. So with that, I'm open for a motion.
Commissioners, that will be Resolution 39.
Resolution number what?
39.
39. Very good.
I'll make the motion, Mr. Chair, that we approve Resolution number 39.
Second that.
And a second. Fatima?
Commissioner Harvey?
Aye.
Commissioner Frohr?
Aye.
And Chair Jenkins?
That would be an aye for me. And I'm very excited about it. Thank you. Very good. So action item one is approved. Next on our agenda is request for approval of a resolution of Weber County, of the County Commissioners of Weber County, providing notice of its intent to appoint a member for the Weber Human Services Board. Matt Wilson.
Commissioners, Matt Wilson is not here, but Director Kevin Eastman is here to assist in the presentation of this item. This is to fill a vacancy on the Weber Human Services Board.
Part of that. Kevin? This is an appointment that we held up last week.
Yes, it is. Yeah, apparently you didn't have the names before you. Don't know what happened with that, but we make sure I've got them for you today.
All right, go ahead.
I appreciate the opportunity to address you this morning. As you're aware, the Weber Human Services has a governing board. That governing board consists of the three Weber County commissioners. We have an interlocal agreement with Morgan to provide services as well, and so of their seven-member council, there are two representatives appointed to that board, totaling of five, and then we have three community at-large positions, and one of those is the vacant position right now. And so our advisory council bylaws, our community partners get together and they brainstorm names. And then the process is brought before you and then sent to Morgan for the final approval, and then we can have this person in place. So I have three names before you, and would like to just recommend one of these individuals that we think would be the most qualified. As these three at-large positions serve on the board, we try to cover all of the areas that Weber Human Services provides services in. We try to provide a community at-large person that is over the aging services, one that has knowledge of substance abuse, and one that has knowledge of mental health. And this individual works for Intermountain McKitty Hospital and manages the receiving center on mental health issues up at the hospital. His name is Clint Thurgood, and I hope you have those. Do you have the three names now before you, or?
We do not, just so you know. We were never given those names.
No. I have them listed if you'd like me to.
I don't know the process. I figured that they would have the three or on the computer or something that they could see them. But.
No, they're not on the computer.
So the bylaws require that no less than two names be presented to you for consideration. So
the three
names I have are Clint Thurgood, Kim Tyler, and Timothy Yanni?
Yanni.
Timothy Yanni? Y-A-N-N-I?
So, commissioners, we haven't had time to really vet these. So, do you want to move on these? Do you want to hold this up a week? What would be your pleasure here? I'm not sure what to even say.
Normally speaking, in the other boards that I sit on, is the board makes a recommendation based on, they give us a recommendation based on order of they feel would be best suited for the vacant position. And I don't know that this has been done in this particular circumstance, has it, Mr. Beisterman?
Well, the board hasn't discussed this. They know of the vacancy, but it's our advisory council, our community partners, that recommend the names.
Oh, great.
They did participate in this.
So that, which is even better. So it's not that so that we have basically an auditing group for the board that recommends the name to the board. And that makes sense to me. So are these the names that group came up with in this particular order?
Yes.
So your recommendation does that we appoint Clint Thurgood?
Yes.
It's not Mr. Eastman, it's the
board.
The board, not the advisory board,
it's the advisory council.
Advisory council.
Our partners, yes.
Yeah, as long as this has been looked at by a separate group, I would be very uncomfortable if we didn't have some other people look at this and vet these candidates. But can you assure us today that then that has been done and this is your recommendation?
Yes, it has been presented to our advisory council, and of the names, this is the one that we would like to see appointed.
With that, Mr. Chair, I'm ready to make a motion. Yeah. So I would recommend to take the recommendation of the advisory council that Mr. Clint Thurgood be appointed to that position.
I'll second that.
Very good. I have a motion and second to appoint Clint Thurgood. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Mr. Commissioner.
Opposed? That's resolution. Number what?
40.
Number 40.
Faulkner. Commissioner Harvey.
Aye.
Commissioner Farrar.
Aye.
And Chair Jenkins.
Aye. Very good. That's been approved. Thanks. Kevin?
Can I ask a question?
Uh-huh.
Because I'm worried. What will be the process to make sure that the Morgan County Council has the name? I'm assuming now that they've, okay.
I will send a copy of the resolution to Jan Ferris, the county attorney there.
Just where you haven't received the names before and you still don't have them before you. I just don't understand how to get that there.
But. What will happen, it'll just be the one name that is submitted to Morgan County for consideration. If they're in agreement, it will be brought back to the Weber County Commission for final appointment.
Great, thanks. Appreciate it, sir.
Thank you, Kevin.
Great. Next up is request for approval resolution between Weber County Commissioners of Weber County appointing a new member to the Weber County Board of Adjustments. Mr. Grover.
Good morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
The Board of Adjustment is made up of five members, two alternates. They look at appeals with land use codes, things of that nature. Fortunately, in the last 2 years, they only had to meet three times, so that's been nice for them. But this is a board that's appointed by the commission, and as you look at the names, there's two names there. Doug Dixon, he has served on the board. He served a term there. The term is 5 years. We also have Laura Warburton as Staff has looked at both of these candidates. They're both excellent candidates. Doug would like to serve again, but Laura has served on the Planning Commission, and either one of them, in my mind, would do a great job. As we're presenting those names before you, we don't feel like you could make a good or bad decision with either one of these individuals.
Commissioners, Gage, this is your area up there.
Well, I actually know both these individuals, both highly qualified, both very professional. This is a tough decision. I know Laura, from her experience on the Planning Commission, has been very effective. Mr. Dixon, I'm sure, is in the same category. So I'm going to leave it up to one of the other commissioners to make the recommendation.
Commissioner Harvey?
How many terms has Mr. Dixon served?
One.
You know, I love the fact that we've got people who are willing to serve and help Weber County in different things. I think that's wonderful. You know, both are hardworking, both are good decision makers. This becomes a tough decision where you have two who are willing to serve. Both have great experience. You know, in considering what we have there, and because that they don't meet frequently, I'd like to give others an opportunity to serve, and I think because of that, I'd like to suggest, or I'll make a motion, if you're willing to accept, Mr. Chair. I'll make a motion that we move forward the name Laura Warburton to serve on that Board of Adjustments.
I'd second that, Mr. Chair.
Resolution 41, Commissioner Harvey.
Aye.
Commissioner Farrar.
Aye.
And Chair Jenkins.
I'm going to vote no because I hate to kick Doug off, but I know Doug very well, and I know Laura very well, and they're both very good people that are qualified, so we're in good hands. Thank you.
It's always nice when we have such qualified candidates.
Mm-hmm. Very good. The next up is a resolution. Weber County, or the commissioners of Weber County, appointing two members to the Ogden Valley Planning Commission. Rick, go ahead.
So this is a 7-member board, and the Planning Commission, they do meet a lot more frequently than the Board of Adjustments. They typically have the Ogden Valley Planning Commission meets twice a month. We have four candidates here. Janice Lopez, Laura Warburton, and I'd recommend that you take Laura off of that because now she's on the board. Because what the board does is they look at recommendations from the Planning Commission and then they look at appeals from that, and so it would be a conflict of interest. So we would recommend that you look at three candidates here. And the first one again was Janice Lopez, Jeffrey Burton, and Chris Hogue. Chris Hogue is currently serving on this Planning Commission. He's done a great job. Jeff Burton would do a great job as well. I don't know much about Janice Lopez. It looks like in her resume she has some architecture experience, but as staff looks at this, Chris Hogue and Jeff Burton would be our recommendations.
Say that again.
Chris Hogue and Jeff Burton would be our recommendations.
Thank you.
Commissioner Brewer, do you want to make any comments on this?
Yeah, I would. I'm somewhat familiar after looking at Ms. Lopez's resume that I know that she has a desire to serve. I also know Jeff Burton fairly well and know from his experience as an attorney, I think would be a very valuable asset to the Planning Commission. Yeah. And I feel that Chris Hogue, with his experience with both Ogden Valley issues as well as water, since he does work for Weber Basin, and a lot of the issues, commissioners, that we see now in the valley deal with water, and so I would let again Commissioner Harvey make the recommendation, but I would support the recommendation of the staff as well.
I'm comfortable with that recommendation from staff on that. So with that, if you'll entertain a motion, Mr. Chair, I'll make the motion that we appoint the recommendation from the staff, Jeffrey Burton and Chris Hoag, to serve on the Ogden Valley Planning Commission.
That's Resolution 42.
Second.
Yep.
And a second for Commissioner Frohr. Fatima?
Commissioner Harvey?
Aye.
Commissioner Frohr?
Aye.
And Chair Jenkins?
Aye. Very good. So next is number five, approval of resolution of County Commissioners of Weber County appointing two members to the West Weber Planning Commission.
So currently we have spots up for Jennifer Wellner and Blake Hancock. And what we, on all these boards, we try to have their terms expiring June 30th of each year, and we only have one or two so that we don't have the whole board or planning commission expiring. That way we keep trained people on there. The four people we have here, they're all qualified. Jennifer Wellner would like to seek reappointment. Blake Hancock is not seeking reappointment. Jennifer has done a great job while serving on there. Wayne Andriotti, he has served on the Planning Commission before and did a great job. He took a year sabbatical. He wanted to go tripping around the world, and so he's done that, and he's wanting to come back and serve, and when he was on there previously, he did a great job. Eugene Atkinson and Dan Baugh, they would also do a good job serving on the commission. As staff has reviewed these names, we would recommend that you consider Jennifer Wellner and Wayne Andriotti, but the other two would do a good job as well.
Very good. Commissioner Harvey. you got any comments on them?
Well, you've got to thank you, Mr. Chair. You know, there's a lot of things going on out in West Weber County. And again, people serve with little thanks, but do it. They carry a pretty heavy load out there. Two or three of the folks on there, and they're all able applicants, but I think I'd like to defer a comment to the two of you, since you know, you've been around the block and know more.
Around the block. Commissioner Frohr?
Excuse me, been around the block several more times.
Or 10 or 12. Who's counting? I would agree that, you've got four qualified candidates here. I tend to agree with Commissioner Harvey that as we look at the future of West Weber County, it's great to have some experience. I know that Mr. Andriotti has been on there before, as I believe Mr. Atkinson has as well. And also it's good to bring people back that have some experience that maybe offer a little different insight than what we have with current members. So, with that, Mr. Chair, I'd make a motion that we recommend Mr. Atkinson and Mr. Andriotti as members of the West Weber County Planning Commission.
Atkinson and Andriotti. I'll second that.
Very good. I have motion a second. You know, I haven't talked to Jennifer, but I've talked to Dan Baugh, and I've talked to Gene Atkinson, and I know Wayne, and so I have no problem supporting your motion here.
Thank you.
So I'm anxious. We have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Excuse
resolution.
Me.
Resolution.
Oh, yeah, resolution. Thank you. Fatima?
Commissioner Harvey?
Aye.
So hold on. So this is resolution 43.
43. Commissioner Harvey?
Aye.
Commissioner Frohr?
Aye.
And Chair Jenkins?
Aye. Very good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Rick. Appreciate that. Next, number six, request for approval of a contract by between Weber County and Levi Hopkins for secure services as the assistant director of the 2019 Kids Act Up. Cassie Bybee.
Hello.
Hello. How are you today?
Good. I'm good.
Good morning.
Good morning. So
you're busy. You're busy right now.
Yeah, we are. We're busy.
A lot cooking.
Yeah. But that's good. That's good.
It is.
It's good to be busy. So Levi Hopkins, what it is assistant director. He assists in with the director of Kids Act Up. So we have a director as well as a music director. And so both 6, 7, and 8 are all three assistants. These are theater students that come in and help assist with the Kids Act Up program.
That's great.
So what they should have, you know, we were... There was a little bit of a misunderstanding, and so instead of having their contracts presented with the director and the musical director that has
So instead of an assistant director, it's to assist
to assist the director. Correct.
So basically, you're giving young people, other younger in the craft, an opportunity to to continue in the other parts of theater, which is
correct.
I think it's wonderful.
Okay. Boy, thank you very much.
We weren't doing this years ago. This is all new. Now we're providing opportunities for others, which is wonderful.
Right. Well, we appreciate the clarification there, Kathy.
It's amazing.
All right, let's buzz right through these. So, motion for one?
I'll make a motion that we approve all three items 6, 7, and 8.
Well, very good. We have a motion for all.
I second that. It's a good way to do it.
And a second. Well, then, if we're going to do that, let's go through the others to make sure we're on top. So number 7 would be, once again, to assist the director.
Correct.
Emma Raines. Uh-huh. Number 8 would be Joseph Kramer to assist the director.
Correct.
Very good. So I have a motion and a second to approve all those. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed. So there's none. Very good. Cassie?
Thank you. And just a little plug reminder, the invite was sent, and so to all the county, but Kids Act Up presents Peter Pan Jr. at noon this Thursday. So
Thursday.
Everyone take their lunch hour, head over to the theater, and enjoy a performance. There's 65 kids from ages 8 to 14 enrolled in the Kids Act Up program this year.
This was one of the funnest theater things I saw last year, commissioners. Yeah. It was.
I'm excited to be there Thursday.
Thursday at noon.
Okay, thank you so much.
So you're going to hang around for just a minute,
yes,
right?
Yes.
I'd like to talk to you.
Okay, we'll do.
Very good.
All
thank
right,
you.
Thanks.
Okay, last on our agenda is request for consideration of an action on a request for final approval for Edgewater Beach Resort Phase 3. Thank you.
Hi, commissioners.
Steve Burton.
Hello. This is the final process for a subdivision known as Edgewater Beach Phase 3. It's part of a planned residential unit development just there south of Pineview. It's gone through the Planning Commission and received the approval. It's now before you. We're looking at 24 units, and some of them are duplexes and some of them are single family. We're also looking at the approval of the improvement agreement to make sure that improvements are installed. That agreement is in the amount of $443,491.97. Staff's recommending approval based on the findings and the conditions, just the findings in the staff report, and the Planning Commission recommended approval as well.
Very good. Questions, Commissioner?
I don't. The fact that the planning up there has reviewed it, and I'm comfortable with that. I've seen the other development up there, and that's a nice place. It'll be good.
You comfortable enough to make a motion?
Unless I'd like to hear if Gage has
it. No, and I would also support a motion, favorable motion. I drive past this a couple times a day, and it's been a development that, in my opinion, has been well managed. The construction appears to be very good. I haven't actually visited one of the units, but it's in a great location. So,
and if it's tough to visit every unit that's being built or constructed in Weber County.
It's tough to do that.
Yeah. I'll make a motion that we approve then, Mr. Chair, if you're ready to accept.
I am.
I'll make a motion that we take action or approve the final approval of Edgewater Beach Resort Phase 3 associated with the subdivision improvement agreement. And it's
there. Okay, second that.
And a second by Commissioner Ford. I have no comment on this either, other than say I've reviewed it and it's a nice subdivision. All in favor say aye.
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 That's unanimous. Thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
Final item on our agenda today is Commissioner comments. Do we have any comments from either of you? Now's the time.
We've got a wonderful press conference tomorrow down at EDC Utah.
Yeah, we do.
That'll take place down in Salt Lake in the afternoon. Looking forward to it.
Good.
Took the words out of my mouth.
How about one more, Gage?
Motion to adjourn.
You need a second?
I don't. Actually, I'll call it. All in favor say aye. 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 Adjourn. No, I don't. You're right.